Hey, lovely people. Just coming on here again to share my thoughts on another topic or situation. But anyway, anywho, I just wanted to come on to talk about this generation, not even this generation, just beliefs and perspectives and our opinions, and also what we choose to receive and what we choose to reject. Now, the reason why I'm coming on to address this is because I'm a believer. I'm a Christian. This is my faith. This is my belief system. I believe in Jesus Christ, and that's my life, okay? Now, the thing that throws me off is people are gonna be people. Okay, let me just say that first and foremost. But what I've learned to understand over a period of time is that you have different types of Christians, okay? And I don't mean no harm in what I'm about to say, but you have the religious-minded Christians, you have the traditional-minded, which also falls under religious minded, then you have people that are more free thinkers, open minded. They're governed by knowledge and understanding. The traditional minded people, the religious minded people, are the ones that may have a bit of knowledge, but they're more governed not so by the truth and by evolving in knowledge, but what has been passed on, or what they believe, or a belief system that has been taught to them without actually learning and understanding it on a deeper level. Okay, I hope what I'm saying is coming through to you. But what I've come to notice is that a lot of religious-minded people, they're not so open, they're not so good at receiving. There are more the Christians that will automatically refuse to receive anything from somebody just because of the way how they think the person look or whatever it is. Okay, case in point. I was around a more older group of Christians, more traditional group of Christians, not this generation, like more seasoned, okay? I say seasoned, you'll see why I say seasoned, group of believers, and it's just the judgmental air that was in the atmosphere was just crazy. Now, why I say this is because there was a conversation that was happening, and they were discussing somebody that was coming to a platform to minister to them, and they automatically disregarded the person because of the person's hairstyle, what the person was dressed, the attire, the tightness or the looseness of the jeans, the color of the shirt, the hair. So I was listening to the conversation and they were like, oh, you know, well, I got on the Zoom and when I saw what the person was wearing, you know, the first thing I came off, because they came off and called each other, and they're just like scrutinizing this person that was about to minister, that was sitting on the pulpit. And they went on to discuss how, you know, Oh, I was surprised when they introduced the individual as a minister because his pants was too tight, or, Jamaican saying his hairstyle looked like a ragamuffin or whatever the case may be. But I say all of that to say this, and I know it took me about 5 minutes to kind of get to what I'm trying to say. But I said all of that to say this. Sometimes we don't know who God is going to use to give us our deliverance, okay? And I say deliverance because that state of mind is a mind that you need to be delivered from. You don't know who God is going to use. It doesn't matter how the person look. It doesn't matter how the person's hair is. If God is going to use that person, or if God has ordained that person as a minister and is going to use that person to give you a word, but you can't see, you have automatically blocked whatever it is that you were supposed to receive because of your opinion, your perception, and your judgments. And a lot of Christians do this, okay? The generation that we're living in now, we're in 2022, okay? People need to be a little bit more open-minded. Just because somebody has piercings, tattoos, locks, weave, lace front, a face full of makeup, nails, hoop earrings, jeans, pants on, or whatever it is that was fed to you through whatever doctrine you were raised in, things are different now, okay? And God is very peculiar in who He chooses to use, okay? So just because the package is not being delivered to you, the message is not being delivered to you in the way you expect it to be packaged of how you expect the person to look, that doesn't mean that God cannot speak through the person, or that the person is not saved, or that the person, oh, how is he ordained as a minister if his pants is so tight? Now, what does the size of his attire or his clothing has to do with his anointing? You didn't even give it a chance. So I'm sitting on the sidelines and I'm listening to the conversation, and they're just going on and on. Oh, when I saw the dude and such, I came off because he looked like a ragamuffin. That's judgment. All of that is just judgment. And we need to do better. And I say we, the body of Christ, need to do better. I'm a part of the body of Christ, so I'm not here to point fingers. But when I see these things, it kind of rubbed me the wrong way, because we're living in a generation where those are the people that God's going to use. They're not going to look like what you're used to, okay? They're not going to look like what you expect them to look like, okay? It's a vessel that God is using. And if you're being distracted by what they look like, there's something in you that needs to be delivered as well. I'm just saying, So if you're distracted by how something looks instead of getting the bigger picture or the message, you're gonna miss out every single time because of your expectation or your doctrines or your religious perspective, your religious-minded perspective that doesn't go beyond that. It's boxed into how you think something is supposed to be. It's boxed by restrictions. It's boxed by judgment. So you'll always come up short, because that very same person that you think don't look like how they're supposed to look, that's the person that could be carrying your blessing. That's the person that could be carrying your deliverance. But you'll never get it because you're looking at how it's packaged and you're not receiving it. So anyway, like I said, we need to do better. We need to give things a chance. We need to give people a chance in the body of Christ, and stop being so judgmental. Stop being so high sedity and super churchy. It's it, And I know I'm probably going to get backlash for this, but I'm at a place now where I'm just going to speak how I feel. And you take what you take and you leave what don't apply, but I'm going to speak my mind. Because I know how I was raised, and I'm stepping out of that box because of that mental place that a lot of older Christians are stuck in. This is why we have a lot of church hurt. We have a lot of disrespect in the church. We have a lot of, just trauma, emotional trauma, because of what we release from our lips, you know, because of our judgmental state of mind. We don't give things a chance. Evolve, grow, learn, research. You know, God didn't call us to be this way. Didn't call us to be this way. And if you're already blocking a soul because of how you think they look, how you expect to win a soul? How you expect for your soul to be saved or delivered from whatever it is that you're going through? If you have already deemed somebody else based on how you think they look or what you're ready to receive or what you're not ready to receive, you know? So, yeah, that conversation was just like, I just kind of sat there and I was just like, okay, here we go, you know, but yeah, there are categories and you got to start to see what side of the fence you're on. What's right and good and true to you, it's not always right and good and true to somebody else. Everybody is governed by different things. Okay, but what Christians need to start doing, what believers need to start doing, is meeting the soul, okay? The spirit. If you're just gonna go off of how somebody look, you already playing the feel wrong. You already playing the feel wrong. Not in this generation, not in 2022, where so many things are evolving, so many things are changing. You know, and being judgmental is never going to get you anywhere quick or fast. It's actually going to block you more. Because it's a limited perspective. It's limited to how you think or what expectation you think should happen. And it's boxed. And you can't box God. You can't limit God on who he chooses to use. All right, so I'm going to go now. Happy Saturday to everybody. And I will talk to you all soon. Have a blessed day. Stay safe.